Mr. Kiddo Doors Radio, WKOR Storytime with your host, the Kid.
Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Kid from Kid Outdoors. And this is something different than my usual vlogs that I do on my YouTube. This is the debut broadcast for my radio show. And I'm pleased to announce that I think it's going to be a big hit. I've mentioned it to several people and talked to them about it. And they said that they think it'll be, they think it's a pretty brilliant idea. So, got a fun and interesting broadcast for you. Is the debut broadcast, so it'll be kind of short. Got some local current events, and then it's pretty much like my Storytime video blogs on my YouTube. It's just this is the radio broadcast. No video, just the audio, but the same entertainment. And one of the things I want to do here is, you know, every now and then I'll have some of my buddies call in and enjoy, or, you know, being part of the show. And so y'all stick around. This is going to be fun. Thank you for that, E.T. Maybe he'll be my little buddy from now on. Maybe I can get him to talk a little faster. So, welcome back. What we're going to do is I'd like to first of all tell you about something that happened Thursday, I do believe. And that was, so this guy's a fireman up in Chattanooga, Tennessee, not far from where I live. I live on the Georgia side. What happened was Thursday, I believe it was, a local fireman, volunteer fireman, at Highway 58, Volunteer Fire Department, Chattanooga, Tennessee. What this man done, are you ready for this? He was arrested for setting a live raccoon on fire. First of all, who does that? I mean, and being a volunteer firefighter, they'll crucify him. How can you be so cruel? Now, I'm all about my hunting, and I'm all about my fishing, and I'm all about my guns. But by God, hunting, you know, we catch a lot of backlash anyway. Oh, you're shooting and killing animals. That's cruelty. No, it's conservation of the animal population, and it's putting meat not only on our family's tables, but your family as well. Because a lot of hunters, I know people that hunt that are vegetarian, and they donate their meats to homeless shelters and soup kitchens. We do a great thing. But to just go out and harm the animal is sick. And I hope he goes down hard for it. It's ridiculous. And I don't agree with it at all. What's worse, or what's as bad, is the local rednecks in the area. Now, I'm Southern. I'm country. Anybody who has ever seen my vlog Storytime on YouTube knows I do not like to be called a redneck. And I catch a lot of backlash from a lot of Southern people, you know, because I talk about how stupid rednecks are. A lot of the rednecks in the area took to social media not long after in support of what he done, as if there was nothing wrong with it. Why? I mean, come on now. Can you imagine the dinner table conversations? What are you going to do tonight, Leroy? Hell, let's go set a coon on fire. Like, what's wrong with you people? I blame drugs. I really do. Because people on Pure Air aren't that stupid. Same day. Which I think I said it was Thursday. I think it was actually yesterday, Friday. The same day in my hometown, at the high school, two 17-year-old boys was arrested. According to the news reports, the local news reports, it was because of the two boys had a weapon in the classroom. The liberals are going to have a field day with that one. The liberals are already having a field day because Dalton made national news. Dalton, Georgia, had a high school teacher carry a weapon into the classroom. And that was just a wild story, as it were. But in my hometown, from the news reports, the speculation is that these were two country boys. One of them owned a pistol, wanted to sell it. His buddy, who was also a country boy. And everybody knows I'm into my guns. I love my pistols. I love my revolvers, okay? I mean, people just don't understand. It's not the gun that kills. It's the idiot behind it. Now, these two boys did not go into the classroom with a weapon with the intent of shooting up the school. The gun was unloaded. Regardless, that doesn't excuse the fact that you carried it into the classroom like a retard. Can I say that? Well, I'm going to. Because it was a retarded move. How stupid can you be? He wanted to sell the gun. His buddy wanted to buy it. The speculation is that these two friends, the best time for them to meet and see each other would be during school hours. Now, you could have left the gun in your truck and told your buddy, hey, you know what, it's bad enough. We have to do this because we can only meet during school hours, so we do it in the parking lot. So let's meet at our trucks after school. If we get caught, the biggest thing will be a fine. No, you want to take it in the classroom and conduct your business in the classroom. So the two boys were arrested. Now, I don't know what the charges are, okay, but I do know that what could have been a fine ends up now being serious jail time for the two boys. I don't get that. Drugs, man. It's got to be drugs. Because people on Pure Air don't do that. Of course, I've always said, too, you know, that there's something in the water down here. Because there's a lot of stupid people doing absolutely just mind-numbingly stupid things. I'm guilty of doing some mind-numbingly stupid things in my past. When I became a father, I grew up, and I grew up quick. Because I wanted what was best for my boy. You know, I wanted to be the best responsible parent that I could be. But those two news stories just, I couldn't get over them. Like, the volunteer fireman setting a live coon on fire. Who does that? And then you've got the two teenage so-called country boys carrying an unloaded weapon into the classroom to conduct business of a sale. Of the said firearm. Human life never ceases to amaze me. This is Kid from Kid Outdoors. We'll be right back. Well, like I said in the beginning of this broadcast, this is the first show. And I wanted to make it a short one, you know, just a short debut, you know, just kind of a taste as to what this radio show will be. Remember to like and subscribe on my vlogs on YouTube. Follow me on Twitter at GavinsDad1113. And there's an underscore in between Gavin's and Dad. So, you know, and follow me on Twitter, like my YouTube, subscribe and everything. If you have any interesting topics you would like to discuss, any of our listeners or any of my listeners, comment, give me a shout on Twitter, comment on YouTube. Tell me. I'll talk about it. No religion, no politics. I'm big into my faith in the Lord, and I'm, you know, diehard about my religion. I am a conservative. I'm a proud Trump supporter, but that's my personal stuff. I don't care what you are, and I'm sure you don't care what I am. And I'm a very blunt, straight up, honest person. I don't sugarcoat nothing. And some of the harshest arguments in the world are religious and political. So, any topics, no religion, no politics, that you would like to hear me rant and rave or talk about, drop me a line. And I'll see what I can do. So, and if you'd like to help out with the show, let me know. So, we'll cut this debut show off. And this is the KIDD. And y'all stay country. I'll see you later.
Shakespeare. WKOR, Restored Time FM, Cat Doors Radio.